Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In times of distress and difficulties, we tend to call upon the Almighty through supplication, through dua, more than at any other time. Dua is a believer's way of connecting to the Almighty at any time, in any place, day or night. Raising hands in supplication, asking for divine help, invoking the mercy and forgiveness of Allah. Dua incorporates praise, thanksgiving, hope, and calling Allah to assist those in need. We are reminded in the Quran, وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ إِنَّ رَبِّي رَحِيمٌ وَدُودٌ. So ask your Lord to forgive you your sins and turn towards Him in repentance, for surely Allah, the Lord, is a dispenser of grace, most loving. Prophets throughout history always had a most special relationship with the Creator, turned to Him in times of distress and need, and they never forgot to praise and thank Him for the countless blessings in their lives. We turn to Allah because we know that He alone can ultimately lift our sufferings and solve our problems. Although making dua is not an obligation, feeling closeness to Allah that comes with sincere dua is a remarkable experience in itself. It increases faith in those who are optimistic. It gives hope to those who are disheartened. It brings relief to those who are distressed, and it saves the supplicants from despair and isolation. Throughout the Quran, we read, Ud'u Rabbakum. Allah encourages the believer to call on Him. The act of dua is in itself extraordinary and of significance. It is the most uplifting, liberating, empowering and transforming conversation a person could ever have. It is a special, intimate communication indeed. It is said that if you want Allah to talk to you, read His revelation. In other words, if you want Allah to talk to you, read the Quran. And if you want to talk to Allah, make dua. Shukran. Wassalamu alaikum. ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.